Welcome along to another episode of the Rated RR podcast. Xiao Raushan together with Rish Roshan Rai. And we're happy to report once again that we're giving you two for the price of one. Two footballers who've been in the headlines recently and not just for their last name. They've actually been in the headlines for things they're doing on the football pitch. And we are so excited to have Irfan Fandi and Ilhan Fandi together with us on the show. Guys, how are you doing? Irfan, start with you.
Thank you so much for having me. I've been watching all of your videos and I'm very happy with what you guys are doing for Singapore football. So it's an honor to be here. Thank you.
In my case, I just want to say, first of all, thank you so much for having me. Yeah, it's an honor to be on this podcast. And also, I've watched your previous ones with Saifullah and Hami. It's quite fun. So I'm really happy to be here. Yeah.
Yeah, it's an honor for us as well to have you guys on the show. And we spoke to your brother Iksan a couple of episodes ago. So it's great to sort of have the two of you on here as well. Irfan, want to start with you. And, you know, since you moved to BG Patom United, you've been very successful, actually, since you've gone there. You won the second division. You won the T1 League last season. And then recently you won the Champions Cup as well. What has sort of... You know, how have you sort of settled in so quickly and become such an important part of this BG Patum side?
I feel like before I came here, I always had a goal in mind. Like when I want to come to a team, I know that I'm going to give my best. And coming to such a great big team, they didn't deserve to be in Division 2 in the first place. So the goal for me from day one was to be a champion in Division 2. And we got that. We came to Division 1, same thing for me. I always want to end the year with an achievement, and we got the champions as well. So for me, I'm very happy and grateful for being in this team and just to improve myself in being in this team.
Yeah, but you know, I mean, for footballers, at times people always say, you know, you give them some time to settle and things like that. But for you, it seemed to happen very quickly.
Yes, for me, fortunately, the people here in Thailand are so nice, so respectful. And I felt like I was already part of the team before I even came to the team. And so the coaching staff, even the players, they helped me, how do you say, get used to the style of play, even the culture in Thailand. And I think that's what made it the transition so easy for me. And that way I became confident and comfortable playing in Thailand.
Ilhan, just coming to you now, speaking of good runs, good form, you are on a good goal-scoring run at the moment. Your team is doing fabulously well. I think 3 wins in your last 5 games or something. I do want to ask you what's the reason for that whole transition. But before that, can I just clear what happened in the post-match against Geylang? What was this about? Please, clear it up for us.
Okay, I mean, this is football. Things happen on the pitch. But whatever stays on pitch, stays on the pitch. Whatever's outside, just stay outside. But no, it's just I was having a bit of fun, you know. The fans, as per normal, that's why they make the game enjoyable. They obviously chant like some stupid things, try to put you off, which make
what you say? But then you tell me,
which like makes it fun, you know. Because we wouldn't be playing football without the fans, you know. We play football for the fans and all. So, but it's just a bit of fun, and they just got on my nerves a little bit, but. No hard feelings. I just had to celebrate in that way. And like, yeah, I mean, without the fans, we won't be playing. Yeah.
Speaking about getting under your nerves, the motivation and stuff like that, how have Young Lions turned this season around since the season resumed? And you guys have been almost, I dare say, a different team since July.
I think it goes down to each individual and everyone trying to give 110% in every game. We know we are not as experienced as everyone says, but no matter what, we still give 110% playing high-pressing football and trying to play a good brand of football and trying to entertain. And then now we are starting to score more goals and people are looking out for us, which is a good thing. And hopefully we can stay grounded and just improve throughout the season and bring it to our AFC. And yeah.
Hey, listen, guys. Irfan brought up a nice thing just now when Ilhan was answering that question, because obviously you guys will chat to each other, right, about issues that go on and things like that. And you know, there's obviously going to be a lot of attention, and at times there will be jealousy, you know, and things like that. How do you all deal with that as a family?
Irfan, you want to go first?
Yeah,
go ahead, you Irfan. Can go first. okay.
To be honest, I think Irfan, you go.
Okay, go.
Okay, fine. I'll go. To be honest, with all this jealousy, or you're playing football just because of your father, you're in the team just because of football, I feel it's good. I like it. I like it that way because it makes me want to work even harder and prove the haters wrong. And not because I don't like the haters, but they motivate me to do even better. So I always change all that negative vibe into a positive one to try and make use of it. And like, if I just there listening to all these comments and all, I will never like reach my goal. So I just want to thank them for that. And it will always make me work harder. Yeah.
Irfan, your turn.
Okay, so what he said was actually what I grew up before, like Ilhan and Iksan. I was having, I think, one of the hardest time because I had to break out of my father's shadow. I mean, the first child playing the Lion City Cup, and then I had to score and all this stuff. So before that, prior to that, I had a lot of, doubters. Many people questioning me whether I can even play football. So maybe a few years ago, I had this quote where I said, hate is my superior motivation. And what Ilhan's going through right now, because he's a striker and he has to score. And so I know how he feels. And like he said, more haters, the better we get, the more we can prove to them. And this is just a feel for us as footballers to get better and to prove them wrong. And so I'm very proud of my brothers, you know, doing so well, especially Ilhan now. He's only 18, but already scored so many goals in the league and he's doing super well. I hope he can go overseas very soon.
Yeah, guys, incredible. Great stuff. Wonderful insight. And yeah, look, I mean, it's fantastic. You know what, you'll sort of, as you said, Irfan, the things that you got to sort of break through, you know, being that child of Fandi Ahmad, legendary Singapore striker. Yeah. And you guys are carving your own careers in your own right. And, you know, and doing good things on your own as well. Let me bring it back to BG Patom, Irfan. This one is for you. And that change in coaching staff, you know, you had Dusit previously. Vidmar has come in. And I kind of wanted to ask you, actually, what sort of tactical changes has Vidmar made to the way BG Patom are looking to play this season?
I can say that with more confidence that I feel like my team this season is much more aggressive in pressing. Last year, I feel our pressing wasn't great because we kind of took the easy way out, but I felt like last year's formation and the players we had, we were good at low block defending and with the counter attacks, and then we scored by set pieces. So I think that was a great asset to our team. But this year, I feel with the new players in and Vidi's new style, I feel like with high pressing, aggressive style play and quick passing, I think it's a whole new team. I think we play a very, very new style and it's very exciting football to watch.
Yeah, no, I don't know whether we'll be getting another centre-back as your top scorer this season as we had with Cardoso last year.
You never know. Cardoso is a big man. He's a real threat. And penalties as well. He got 100% record in penalties. So I don't think anyone's going to take his place as a penalty taker.
Ilhan, coming to you now. You have obviously worked on your game a lot. I've seen you grow throughout this season as well. And you're pressing. It's like you never stop running up front, man. And Hami told us last week, the Jurgen Klopp style of pressing is something Coach Philip Orr likes to drill into the team. What have you learned from him in terms of how to develop your game as a striker?
I mean, I've learned a lot under Coach Nasri and Coach Philip, because Coach Nasri was the first to start. And then now Coach Philip, I've learned a lot from both the way of pressing, because I'm not a natural striker. So, I mean, the team hasn't got a natural striker. So they asked if I could play there. I'll do anything for the team and just to play and enjoy football. So, yeah, my pressing is getting slightly better each day because Irfan, Iksan know how bad mine was a few years ago. Like, I can't press. But then now I'm slowly getting the hang of it and getting to know my actual role. And the players around me always help me and guide me. I'm there to learn. Even though we are the same age, like around the same age, I always try and say, me and Joel are the ones up top. Usually, I always say, Joel, you have to talk to me. And even if you know I'm not doing so well, just tell me how I can improve and things like that. So, and with Coach Philip, he instills a lot of hard work. Like he said, like, we are a young team, not much experience, but we can go there and apply a lot of pressure and they can throw the ball away and things like that. So, yeah, both coaches, I'm very happy that I've got to learn very little details that I can bring to my game. So thank you to Coach Najee and Coach Philip. Yeah.
And just quickly touching on that.
Sorry, Karen. Karen,
just quickly touching on that, Ilhan, you've also had the chance to train with the national team now. So Tatsuma as well has played a part in your development as well. How much have you enjoyed that? Because it's fairly new to you compared to your brothers.
You know, I treasure every moment because like I always wanted to play with older players. And during Lions of Time, I'm watching some of the players that's now playing the national team and I'm with them now. Training with them is always a learning curve for me. I know my time is just slowly coming, but I want to try and give 100% and just fight for sport and always there to learn. And yeah, I want to give a big thanks to all the senior players for making me feel so welcome when I joined for the Saudi trip. So yeah, that made me more comfortable and at ease. And with
you're welcome. I'm joking. I'm still junior.
And for Coach Tatsuma, he's always given like a lot of motivation for me to go on and try and do like he always tells me to express myself in the attacking third and things like that. So it gives me more freedom basically, you know. Yeah.
I quite like the variation in your runs, actually, Ilhan. When I watch you play for the Young Lions, it's quite good. You know, you're able to drop deep at times, link up the play, run into the channels in certain situations. So it's good variation in terms of your attacking play in those areas. And talking about development, which is something that you touched on, and Irfan, I want to go to you here because, you know, you've spoken previously about learning from the likes of Tunez, learning from the likes of Cardoso. How exactly have those guys helped the development of your game? Are there any specific things that you can sort of give us some insight into?
Okay, so as you know, they played, especially Tunez, he's played in the La Liga, he played against Cristiano Ronaldo, yes. Messi, all the biggest names, he's played against all of them. So anything he tells me, I say yes and I listen to him and I learn from him because you're getting it from the best. He's the best. He's the best defender in the league. And so any opportunity that I can learn from him, I learn. We have a joke that I call him my father in the team because he takes at me like a son. So, yes, in the past two years with him, it's simple things that he's been teaching me, you know. More, not really on the field, but more to mentality, what goes on in your mind. I think that's very important. He always tells me that as a defender, you can't really make that many mistakes. But if you do make a mistake, you should never ever ponder over it. You should just get over it. And focus on the next thing because you're the last line of defense. You cannot make a mistake. So he always tells me, just forget what happened. Get to the next one, you know. Focus on the next thing. And for Victor, he's defensive masterclass, you know. He's a no-nonsense defender. No such thing as small passing behind, you know. If he cannot, he cannot. He clears the ball. So he's a very basic and thorough defender. And so all these small things I learned from them. I learned so much. Every day I learned something from them. And they, the other way around also, they learn from me a lot of the times. I think as a back three defense, we work together so well and we learn from each other. And I think that's why we're so successful last year.
Yeah, I think talking about the back three, it brings me nicely into my next question because I want to talk about systems a little bit. You know, at times you need to play a back three and we sing it with the Singapore national side as well. Sometimes it's a back four with two central defenders, for example. I know you and Madhu or you and whoever it is in those situations. Is there a preference for you in terms of one system over the other where you feel you do a little bit better in a back three or in a back four perhaps?
So for me, when I'm playing as a back four, it was a bit difficult, to be honest, in the national team. I tried my best, but because I've been playing the back three for the whole 2 years before actually playing in national team in Saudi. Yeah. So it was kind of awkward for me, but I tried to put whatever I can, you know, onto the field. But for me, I feel much more confident playing as a back three. I feel like as a back three, you have more stability in the back. At the same time, when you attack, you have more options down the left wing and the right wing. But yeah, I also have the pace as a right center back, and better I can bring the ball up higher rather than being a back four and you center back. You're kind of static in the middle, so I kind of like the back three better. Yeah.
Ilhan, you play up front just like your father. Must be big shoes to fill, as you all touched on earlier. What kind of advice does Fandi Ahmad give his son before a game or even after a game? And we know Iksan watches your games a fair bit as well. So what sort of advice comes from your family?
My dad always tells me to be strong up top, and also he always tells me, Ilhan, you have to make runs. You have to make runs. You have to demand for the ball. Because if you don't ask for the ball and you don't get the ball, then there's no point having your skills and whatever because you aren't able to show it. So I take a lot. I try and demand for the ball as much as possible and try to make runs. And yeah, so I take a lot of small details from my dad. And yeah, because he's a striker and yeah.
Okay, here's a question. What's the biggest difference between Coach Fandi and Father Fandi? Both of you played with him in dual roles, right? What's the biggest difference? I see Irfan already laughing. So Irfan, you want to go first?
Coach Fandi and Father Fandi. No difference. Yes, on the field, you know, he's very serious, very tactical. He needs to get what he wants on the field. And that's very good from a coach. You know, I think that's very important. But off the field, you know, he's amazing that he takes care of everything for us. And he still gives us advice, especially after the games. After the games, it's not really like a coach telling you what you should have done better. It's more like a father figure, what you can improve on most of the time. And I feel like that you have the best of both worlds. So what else can you ask for?
Ilhan?
The biggest difference between Coach Fandi and Father Fandi is that Coach Fandi is like, when it's the coaching time, he treats everyone the same. And like, if he has to shout at you, he shouts at you no matter what, even if you're son or what, because we have to be professional about it. It's football, you know. But when it's Father Fandi, it's a lot of jokes, 24/7. But when you do a joke on him, he's not really happy about it. But it's all banter. So, yeah. But like Irfan said, after a game, it's usually like, it's like he'll tell you what you should have done better, but in a nice way. And for you to think about it lah also. Because as a player, if you know you had a bad game, you should know yourself. You can't always be like, I had a bad game, but oh, I think I did very well. Like you can't, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you have to, that's how you improve. So
you got to be honest with yourself, and you can't be delusional about what you're putting.
Yes.
Yeah, you have to be honest with yourself. If not, I think and
at the same time,
you're right.
You have the very important, I think, in Singapore that a lot of players, they don't accept criticism. I think that's the most obvious thing I think we're lacking. And I feel like if we try to accept it and learn from it, we'll be much better players. Yeah.
I think it's interesting that you say that, because I was just going to ask actually, because you brought about talking about mentality, and then Tunez was talking to you about that, and you know, saying that things you got to forget, mistakes on the pitch and things like that. Do you guys have strategies to try and make yourselves mentally stronger, or try to cope with criticisms or difficulties that you might face along the way in your very young careers? Shall we start with Irfan first?
All right, sure. Okay, so I think the biggest one was usually when, okay, you have a game, let's say national team, and we do badly. The first thing is you should never read comments. That's what a lot of people say.
Smart.
That's what a lot of people say.
Smart.
Yeah. But for me, I cannot not read. You know, sometimes you always wonder at the back of your mind, what are people trying to say? So for me, I still go and read.
Okay.
I will read. I'll read and I will try to, okay, some people, maybe, yeah, okay, they mix. Some of them, they have quality critiques, you know. Like, okay, good criticism, and you have to accept it. But some, you know, it's nonsense. But so for me, when I read this stuff, I kind of like think to myself, okay, this guy is right. I can improve. I can get better. And some people cannot accept this. And I feel like that is a big part of football. You have to accept criticism to get better. And like even Tunes, he's such a strong character. I've never met someone with such a strong character. That's why he made it big. And mentality in football is so important, just as important as physicality, maybe even more. Yeah. Mm.
Ilhan, what about you, man? You're a young man. You're starting to face up with all this criticism coming your way as well. How do you go about dealing with these things?
I mean, for me to go about all these things is to put up a good performance.
Do you read the comments?
Yeah, I do. I do. Like, I can't, like Irfan said, I cannot see the comments because sometimes the comments is right and sometimes it's not laugh. But then sometimes it makes me laugh and, like not being harsh or anything, but, oh, you want to talk? Okay, let's see the next game, you know. But
okay,
this watch makes football fun. And yeah, but sometimes if it's a comment that you know is not right, then I think just block it off, you know. So yeah, so just block it off. And yeah, I think for me in my case, I think if like things like this happen, I think I just want to put up a good performance and show that, oh, maybe it's just a bad game, a previous bad game, you know. Yeah, so everyone has their ups and downs, so it's just
I don't know if y'all have watched The Last Dance on Netflix, the Jordan, the series about Jordan and Michael Jordan.
I think I did.
You should check it out, man.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, check it out, man.
Good,
I mean, I don't know whether I would recommend the way he deals with teammates and all that, like, because at times he can stretch into bullying and things like that. But he takes things like incredibly personally, you know, like you guys say, someone might say, hey, Ilhan doesn't deserve to be in this position or whatever. Mm. You'd be like, okay, fine. That's what you think, fine. I'm going to show you. So, you know, it was really enjoyable.
Okay, like what you just said, like Ilhan doesn't deserve to be in that position. Yeah. Okay, my reply is, put somebody else. Who are you going to put? Yeah. In that time, who are you going to put?
Yeah.
You know? That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah. Sometimes some comments don't make sense. Yeah. Some people don't understand football, and that's why you need to forget about it at times. You just some comments just don't make sense. You cannot ponder over it. You know, just forget it.
Yeah. You got to channel the bad ones out and take in the constructive ones. Sorry, at this point, both of you admitted to reading comments. I just want to know, do you all have a WhatsApp group where you're sharing? Did you see what this fool said? You know what
no,
I mean?
No,
do you,
usually it's,
do you share
it's right
it or
there
is it private?
There.
Okay.
No,
okay,
it's right there. You know? It will be in the group and it was like, oh yeah, look at this, and we laugh about it. Or somebody says something very harsh and we're like, oh my God, you know, what footballers would say to each other, you know? I cannot say here, but yeah.
Oh, you can. Look, it's good that you guys have got a nice support base, and you know, and in the dressing room as well, if you've got friends, you can talk about it to each other, have a laugh about it, or even just address it. Look, I get criticisms as well, being commentator on TV. And that's just the way it is. Sometimes I also go and see the comments.
you cannot please everyone. You cannot please everyone.
Okay, let me get us back on track. And actually, I wanted to highlight this bit where Ilhan's sitting in a car. For those of you listening to us on Spotify, if you're on YouTube, no problem. You can see exactly what's happening. But if you're on Spotify, Ilhan has actually been very nice, taken some time out of his off day. He's in a car, in a car park. They've done some shopping. And his friend has just run by the window there trying to scare. I thought he was going to get kidnapped for a second. But the reason why I'm bringing up that point is because the only way we could do this with you, Ilhan, was on a weekend because you've got national service commitments.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. So we appreciate that. And which brings me to this question about what unit are you in your national service and how does it sort of work? What kind of support do you get to pursue your footballing career while you're in national service?
Okay. In this part, I can't really say what I do, but I can say like the ups and downs I face.
Mm.
Okay. So in this case, I must say they've given me 100% support as long as I do my job diligently and don't try and play around and things like that. And so I'm very, it's a privilege, lah, as they say, because not a lot of people get to play football while you're in NS. So I appreciate it so much. And every time I go to training, sometimes it may be tired. I wake up 4:30 and then finish work at 6. So it's tiring, but that's the life of a footballer in Singapore. And some people ask me, Ilhan, how is it? I say it's tough, but you just have to basically suck it up, lah, you know?
Yeah, of course.
If you want to become a professional footballer when you're in Singapore, you have to go through NS. And it's just how you stay strong mentally. It's draining. It's draining. Going to training, back to camp. Training, back to camp, game and things like that. But yeah, you just have to stay strong, basically. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think what you guys
have
done is...
If you want it enough, I guess you'll just do it, right? If you want it enough, you're just going to push through and whatever alarm clock that wakes you up at 4 a.m. or that doesn't count for anything. I'm going to do this and this is how we're going to do it, basically. Mentality, man.
Yeah.
Rosh,
as you were, I think the strategy... No, sorry. I was just going to say, I think the strategy of going into NS early. I think, Irfan, you did the same thing as well. Iksan, I think did the same thing as well.
Yes.
To kind of get it out of the way.
Yeah.
To get it out of the way and then move on with your career. Yes. It's a smart one. I mean, there's no escaping National Service for Singapore footballers. So might as well just get it out of the way and get on with it. Okay, anyway, we're running out of time. I'm starting to sound like the old man that I am and blabbering on. Roshan, I'll leave you to whatever final questions you've got.
Okay, just very quickly, between the both of you, I would like to know one quality you admire in the other person. So I guess, you know what I mean? So maybe Irfan can
football
tell me one
what?
Quality. Sorry?
What kind of quality? Football-wise?
Any quality. Just one endearing quality of Ilhan that, Irfan, you really admire and respect.
This my brother. you will never ever see him sad. And he will bring joy to everybody in the family or in a group. You know, he's never sad. He's always he's very joyous. He's a very joyous person, always smiling, and he brings energy out of people. So I think that's a very big quality Ilhan has, and it's amazing to have it.
Wow.
Your turn, Ilhan.
I think for Irfan, he's when he moved to Thailand, he's matured tremendously. Like he takes his own initiative now. When last time this guy don't clean his room, everything, Ilhan clean the room or everything. Iksan knows. Iksan, if you watch this, you know. So I feel that he's matured a lot. Now, like, he take care of the family. Last time, he was very playful and things like that. But now, I see that when he moved to Thailand, he's staying by himself. And he's matured a lot. And we appreciate it as a family. And because he's the first son. And this guy, I don't know. I just hope that he cleans up his room still.
Hey, mate. Hey, my room clean. Now people clean the house for me.
Guys, it's been absolutely fabulous and fascinating to chat with the both of you. I came into this podcast with so much excitement and it's lived up to the billing. Thank you so much. Thank you to the listeners who watched us on Spotify and YouTube as well. Do continue supporting local football and supporting us. Thank you.